Hello student, in this video, we'll learn how to apply geometric constraint in your sketches. So to begin with, please make sure that you have this geometric sketch constraint.ipt open up in your Autodesk Inventor. You will come about this screen. So the first step, go into the model browser under the sketch one, double click on the icon. This will enter into the sketch mode off so that we can manipulate and apply geometric constraint to all these sketches here. So the workflow for this video will be, we will start from the top left-hand corner, move to the right, go to the second column, starting from the left to the right, and then the last row from the left to the right. Okay, let's begin with the first one. So let's zoom in into apply coincident constraint. So where can I find all these geometric constraints? Under the sketch tab, constraint panel, you will see 12 constraints here, geometric constraints. So the first item here, apply coincident constraint, will be the first constraint at the top left here. Okay, so left click once. For coincident constraint, we can apply point to point, point to midpoint, indicated by the green circle, and point to line. So let's try it out. From here, point to point. For the middle line, click on the its point and select the green dot. So we are applying its coincident constraint for this line to the midpoint of the horizontal line. On the last one, point to line. All right. So we can also apply coincident constraint between any other features that has an origin point. Let's say for this circle, it always has points on its center. So we can click here, make it to the origin, here to here. Now, we're going to apply a different constraint. In this, it's the concentric constraint. So concentric constraint is actually third to the right of coincident, concentric, left click once. So what happened here, it works similar to the coincident constraint. However, you are applying on a curve arc to another curve arc. So one, two, you will notice the symbol is slightly different, very closely resemblance of the constraint shown here. And let's do a second practice of it, and we can show the constraint. Now, tangent constraint will be here. Tangent, from the word, I think we are very familiar with applying tangent in AutoCAD. It's just taking the curve to another curve and applying the same. You can apply one more to the other curve to make sure that all three circles here of different sizes are tangent at one single point to each other. Tangent constraint can also be applied of one arc to a line. So click here and here, and you will see this tangent constraint icon appearing on it. So let's say we would like to show all the constraint that has been applied. We press the F8 key on your keyboard. You'll notice a lot of items here. We can click selected items, select constraint, drag it around by left clicking it and move it around. And we can delete it also by pressing the delete key. To hide all the constraint, press the F9 key on your keyboard. Let's reapply the tangent constraint for this fella. And let's move on to the second row. So for this second rows, we are applying collinear constraint. So what happened is, for collinear, it will realign this line to this line. So press on this collinear constraint here and here. So these two lines merge into one. Collinear constraint can also be applied when we have an ellipse. If you notice, if you shift from certain quadrant to another quadrant of the ellipse, there's a different trailing line that appears, whether is it horizontal or vertical. So let's try the horizontal trailing line here, and we apply the collinear constraint on this line itself. So it will constrain that horizontal trailing line that you see on the ellipse onto this fixed slanted line. Applying horizontal constraint. So this is the horizontal constraint. Click once. Horizontal constraint is very useful in two modes. So for the first one, it's just to apply the line to make sure that it's horizontal. But take note, when you hover over a certain entity, there will be a trailing line that appears. Okay, for now, there's none. When I hover over the entity, there will be this horizontal trailing line that appears. Take note of this trailing line, because in some occasion, even though after selecting horizontal constraint, the trailing line will show it as vertical. So that will be the final constraint that you will apply actually. So yeah, just take note of that. So for this case, let's apply the horizontal constraint on these lines to make sure that they are horizontal and parallel to this fella. 1, 2, 3. Horizontal constraint can also be applied onto points. Okay, so let's say we click on here on the point and the point of the fixed line on the bottom here. You see, they extend the line all the way down. We do the same here to the midpoint of the fixed line. It will shift this midline all the way down. And let's do the same for this fella. It also shifted the whole thing downwards. Lastly, for second row, we'll be applying the symmetry constraint. So symmetry constraint is beside the equal constraint. So left click once, select the two entities that you want it to be symmetry to one another. So one here and one here. And the third item, the third selection will be the line of symmetry, which is here. And with that, we have gotten a symmetry effect. To the last row, we will now apply parallel constraint here. Make sure that they are parallel to this fixed line. So parallel constraint is just below the coincident constraint. 1, 2. Okay, let's just practice it again, and for the last time, there. Perpendicular constraint, from the word itself, it says that 90 degrees to the line of the constraint. So click on perpendicular constraint. One, second one, and last will be here. Now, vertical constraint is very similar to the horizontal constraint. You can apply the lines, or you can apply points to points. So apply vertical constraint. As I mentioned, always look out at the trailing line. Okay, this trailing line is shown as vertical, therefore we want it, and we can apply it now. If not, just choose the horizontal constraint to reapply the constraint. So click once. Let's practice again, and last one here. For this vertical constraint, we will be applying points to points, here to here, here to the midpoint, and lastly, this one. So let's compare 1, 2, 3, 4, the horizontal constraints and the vertical constraints. So for the first column here, it's quite straightforward. It applies the horizontal constraint here, and the bottom one applies the vertical constraint. But when you are applying horizontal constraint on points and vertical constraints on points, there's a little bit of difference from one another. So my suggestion is please practice so that you understood what is the different application here. Lastly, the equal constraint, which I find it very useful. Instead of applying dimensions again and again, we can use this constraint to make sure to ensure that all these lines share the same length. All right, we have come to the end of the activity. Thank you.